Until now, there really haven't been any good studies directly looking at the link between exercise and severity of COVID illness. I'm Dr. Mike Hansen, and in this video, I'm going to show you a new study in the British Medical Journal of Sports Medicine that did exactly that. We already have a ton of research that shows us that exercise helps us feel better mentally and physically. It prevents or improves many medical conditions like heart disease, type 2 diabetes, high blood pressure, obesity, certain types of cancer, dementia, and it can extend our lives. That's why the U.S. Physical Activity Guidelines and the American Heart Association recommend at least 150 minutes of moderate physical activity every week. So now let's get to the study that was just done at Kaiser Permanente in California. Now, in order to understand this study, you have to know about something that they were already doing before the pandemic. Healthcare workers there routinely asked all of their patients two simple questions about their physical activity. They would refer to this as the exercise vital sign. The questions were, one, on average, how many days per week do you engage in moderate to strenuous exercise? For example, like a brisk walk. The answer choices are 0 to 7 days. Now, the second question was, on average, how many minutes do you engage in exercise at this level? The answer choices were 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 90, 120, or 150 or more minutes. Now, based on previous research, it turns out these two questions are a good measure of people's activity levels. Not only that, but these two questions predict some medical problems like high blood pressure and high blood sugar. Now, most people already know that there are a lot of health conditions that are strongly correlated with a lack of physical activity, like the ones I just mentioned. A lot of them are also risk factors for having severe illness or death when it comes to getting COVID-19. This includes obesity, high blood pressure, and diabetes. So in this study, they enrolled 48,000 adults over the age of 18 who had confirmed COVID-19 that was diagnosed between January and October of 2020, which was before anyone was vaccinated. All of them were patients at Kaiser Permanente for at least 6 months before testing positive for COVID-19. When they looked in their chart, meaning in their electronic medical record, each patient had at least three of these exercise vital sign measurements in their record. Within this health system link, 43% of patients were Latino or Latinx, 34% were white, 11% were black, and 10% were Asian or Pacific Islander. The breakdown of groups who had COVID-19 were 65% Latin, 18% whites, 7% blacks, and 6% Asian or Pacific Islander.
What?
Toodaloo, motherfucker.
Hey, you can't.
The entire group was divided into three categories. One, those who consistently met activity guidelines of over 150 minutes per week at all three measurements. Let's call this group A. Now, the second group was those who were consistently inactive with only 0 to 10 minutes per week at all three measurements. Let's call this group C. Then there is the third group, those who were active in the range of 11 to 149 minutes per week or who had variability in their three measurements. We'll call this group B. The researchers also looked at other important characteristics of these 48,000 plus patients. How old were they? Were they male or female? Did they smoke or have emphysema? Did they have obesity, diabetes, high blood pressure, cardiovascular disease, kidney disease? And they looked at other factors as well. So they collected and analyzed a ton of data. Then they calculated the risk and correlated that with different outcomes. The big takeaways from the study is that people who were consistently inactive had a significantly higher risk of hospitalization, ICU admission, and death after getting COVID-19 compared with those who were active for at least 150 minutes per week. Also, what they found was that for those who were active over 10 minutes per week, meaning group B, they did have some protection against severe illness or death from COVID-19, but not as much as group A. Now, this was one study looking at the direct correlation between exercise and severity of COVID illness. More studies would be needed to confirm these findings, but based on what we have, it's one more reason to encourage and promote physical activity for everyone. Ideally, a minimum of 150 minutes per week. Certain types of exercise can give more health benefits than others, but they all have overlap. So for example, resistance training or strength training, which includes lifting weights and doing calisthenics. That's especially great, not just for adding muscle and staying strong, but especially great to prevent osteoporosis. Then you have high-intensity interval training, which is especially great for shedding fat. Then you have aerobic training or cardio, which is especially great, not just for shedding fat, but increasing stamina. All of these types of exercises have overlap when it comes to health benefits. Now, I know some people are going to bring up this question, how does exercise, along with healthy eating and getting good sleep, etc., how does that compare to getting the COVID vaccine? Let's say you work out 150 minutes or more per week and you don't have the vaccine. Does that give you the same level of protection? Well, we don't have any studies comparing the two head on. All I can tell you is that with the mRNA vaccines made by Pfizer and Moderna, they're 95% effective against severe COVID. And I seriously doubt that exercising 150 plus minutes per week will get you that same level of protection. So in order to do that study, you would need to do a randomized clinical trial that consists of four groups comparing vaccine, vaccine plus exercise, exercise but no vaccine, and then no vaccine or exercise. But that's a study that will likely never be done for multiple reasons. And on that note, this new Delta variant of COVID, which is the worst COVID strain yet, it's rising in the US and it's soon gonna be the dominant strain, which I talk more about in this video right here. And if you wanna know more about the top 10 benefits of exercise, check out this short and sweet video right here, if you know it's good for you. That's all for this one. Thank you for watching. And if you liked it, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe and bell notification. See ya.